Yes. Wow. Welcome to Professor's Garage. 92,000 miles on the 2017 BMW X3. It's overdue for spark plug replacement. This is the OE replacement part from NGK. Now, NGK says it's not due until 100,000 miles, but on a turbocharged direct injection engine, we should cut the interval into half. And this should have been done at 50,000 miles. This job is straightforward, but you do need the right tools to do it. And one major tool is a spark plug socket. And because of the space inside the well, you need this thin wall socket. 14 millimeter thin wall socket for BMW compared to this larger socket for Honda and Toyota. This is much thicker. This is very thin. 6 point, 12 point. There are springs inside to grab the spark plug when you remove it. This is the N20 engine, but the procedure also works on similar models such as N26. Now, on certain configurations, you may need to remove the cowl to access the cylinder number 4. But I believe we should be able to access it under this particular configuration. Before you proceed with this replacement, make sure the engine is cold. Because when you apply the torque to the spark plug, it will be accurate when the engine is cold. The first is to remove the engine cover. Now, on certain model years, you may have connectors or vacuum hoses connected or as part of the engine cover. So you need to remove those and disconnect them before you remove the engine cover. So make sure you understand what you are getting into. Now, on this particular model year, this is 2017 BMW X3. We do not have the hoses, and I believe we can just simply pull it up and remove it. So on this model, there's nothing on this engine cover. So it's rather simple to remove it. It's important to clean the area to make sure it's dust-free because you do not want to introduce any dust to the working environment. A vacuum and or air compressor will be ideal to remove the dust.
You can also use one of these battery-powered dusters to clean the area. I received this as a test unit and tried it on the interior and under the hood. It did a very good job. 4 adjustable airflow settings. The highest setting has a decent amount of power and blows away a lot of dust under the engine cover. You can feel the quality holding it. It appears to have a decent battery, which delivered impressive power during my 20 minutes of use. Again, this is not a sponsor, but I like the product and will post the link to it. It's a bit pricey too, and I will ask the seller to give us a discount. So check it out in the description.
As you can see, it's a 4-cylinder engine, and there are 1, 2, 3, 4 connectors to the coil packs. Now, if this is your first time replacing the coil packs or spark plugs, it's a good idea to start with the easiest one, which is right here, the number 1 cylinder. To remove the connector, pull one side up, and then you can remove the connector. Once the connector is removed, you can try to pull the coil pack up. It's not too hard, but this has been there for more than 7 years, so there will be some resistance. Pull it out again, pull this up all the way, and then remove the connector. From this angle, you can see the spark plug inside. Go ahead to remove it. Use the thin wall 12-point socket, 14 millimeter with an extension. This extension is 6 inch plus the socket, the total length is 8 inches. Insert this all the way in. Make sure it's engaged, right? You want to push it all the way in so the socket is engaged with the spark plug. Take it off. counterclockwise to take it off. For this particular cylinder, you can certainly add one more or use a longer extension if some of these are in the way. But I also consider the number 4, which is under the cowl. And I think this configuration, this extension will give us enough clearance to do number 4 as well. Longer extension. Pull it straight out. On the tip, it's actually still very good. It looks great. After I pull the spark plug out, you can see there's rust inside. And I definitely don't want the rust to go back into the cylinder. So I will use vacuum to clean it. This creates more suction in the well. Let's see. Okay, very clean. Very good.
I inspected one of the cylinders using an endoscope through the spark plug well. The piston appeared remarkably clean, with minimal carbon buildup across most surfaces except for a small area, perhaps near the intake valves. I plan to clean intake valves at around 100,000 miles on this direct injection engine, as it's prone to carbon buildup from oil and blow-by gases.
New spark plug, it's pre-gap. Always compare the old and the new side by side and make sure they are the same ports with the same port number. Put it back. Never use a power tool for this job, because the last thing you want is to cross thread or to damage the thread. Okay, torque it to 23 newton meter or 17 pound feet of torque. Great! On the old coil pack, you can use a little bit of dielectrical grease. Just a little bit to seal it, so the next time it's easier to get out. Don't apply too much. New ones usually come pre-greased, and you do not want to add additional grease on top of the existing one. Put it back. Okay, push it in. Press the tap and make sure it clicks. Now we are done with the first cylinder. We are going to continue with the second, third, and the fourth. Wiggle it, pull it out. It can be tight. Take your time. Yes. Okay, I can feel it. It's clean, which is great. Now we are on to cylinder number 4. think I'm getting there. Oh, yes. Wow. Yes. Again, make sure it's seated counterclockwise to loosen the spark plug. Let's see if I can get it out. Ah, great. Again, there's rust, so let's clean them out. Let's see. Okay, very clean. Okay, 23 newton meter and 17 pound feet of torque. It's a little bit of dielectric grease. Push the connector in. Press it and click. Now double check everything is connected back and we are going to start the engine. Moment of truth. It all sounds good and looks great. Nothing on the dash except for the hood. The engine runs smoothly. Everything is great.
It's all done for today, and we'll see you in 60,000 miles or so. I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you did, consider giving us a thumbs up and subscribing to Professor's Garage. If Professor can do it, you can do it. Stay dirty, stay safe. Until next time, may the Lord bless you and give you peace. Good night.